focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable.
Welcome to another episode of India's Most Responsible Companies, a special series that puts the focus on all the efforts that India Inc. is making to give back to society. On the show today, we find out how the multi-billion dollar conglomerate Welspun is transforming lives in remote corners of India, like the Kutch district in Gujarat. As part of its various CSR initiatives, Welspun is contributing significantly towards healthcare, sanitation, the environment, women's empowerment, and lots more. Established as a texturizing unit with humble beginnings in 1985, Welspun is one of the largest home textile manufacturers in the world today, exporting an entire range of world-class products in the bed and bath category to over 50 countries. With two state-of-the-art manufacturing facilities in Gujarat, this billion-dollar conglomerate is employing business as an agent of change, touching the lives of millions in the process. Following the devastating Bhuj earthquake of 2001 that brought the entire Kutch district to its knees, the company established the Welspun City, a 2,500-acre township in Anjar, in 2005. Since then, the company, through its presence here, has built back the Kutch region, employing more than 9,000 people from the local community. Welspun today runs various CSR programs in the fields of education, empowerment, environment and health in the areas surrounding its manufacturing facilities in Vapi and Anjar. And now I'm in conversation with BK Goenka, chairman of Welspun, who's here to tell us all about what makes Welspun one of India's most responsible companies. Welcome to the show, sir.
Thank you.
So it's a well-known fact that every fifth tile in the US is produced by Welspun. Some of your tiles also make it to tennis grand slams and various other sporting events of international honor. What is not very well known is the fact that Welspun also has a philosophy of really giving back to society, really transforming lives through its initiatives across education, healthcare, women's empowerment, sanitation. So tell us a little bit about what is the CSR philosophy at Welspun.
CSR at Welspun is primarily not coming that it's a statutory requirement or government has said that we have to spend 2% or 3% of the profit. I think it is coming from the heart. It is in our DNA. It is not today's world. I mean, when I see my grandfather or father, how they used to do the social work in a different way. And I think it is coming from those days when we used to spend 5% of our profit in very early days. And in those days, the issue was like the drinking water, which you used to call like a piau in the village. You know, you have a gausalas taking care of your, relatives, which are not economically well-to-do. So I think it's a part of our DNA. And today, whatever we are doing as CSR, we are doing from our heart.
Right. And so, when and how did you establish the Welspun Foundation, and what sort of a vision did you have for that?
No, Welspun Foundation we established almost like 10 years back. But I think the real work, we started working in the last 5 years, and we have created a complete mission, vision. And for us, it's a long-term vehicle. And it's a vehicle where we want to use our the whole social planning, what we want to do in next in coming years. Right. So right now, we have three E's there. Basically, we are focusing on education, empowering. In empowering, when I say it's more of a woman, and then environment. So the three is a basic philosophy which we are working on it. And we are working closely with our all the areas where we are manufacturing plants across country.
Right. And what sort of CSR spends do you have at this point in time?
So this year we are spending around 15 to 18 crore, but going forward we have a next year target is around 25 crore rupees. So that's every year we are increasing the level of the spend.
Right. And you've done some commendable work in Anjar, in Kutch district in Gujarat. First, I'm curious to know, why did you decide to get into this area that was completely devastated by the Bhuj earthquake in 2001? What made you want to set up a manufacturing facility there? I'm sure it couldn't have been easy to do that.
I mean, it's a very good question. Frankly speaking, when we were doing the expansion at our existing plant at Vapi in Gujarat only, and I met Honorable Prime Minister today and then CM, and he said, you have to go to Kutch. And I was like very shocked to hear, you know, how can you put a textile plant in Kutch when there is no water, no road, no electricity. But I think it was his effort and his support and made us took that decision. And I mean, I'm frankly with the government, state government support that time, we could start the plant within 9 months, and we exported our first towel from the plant in less than 10 months. So it was a big decision, but when we saw that a lot can be done when government is ready to support you.
Right.
And I think it was also part of, you know, a responsible citizen, how can we work together to uplift this whole area? And if we can put this plant here, this is going to have a huge impact on that particular district, which was completely devastated.
Right. And the three E's that you mentioned, education, empowerment and environment, are also seen very visibly in Kutch, where your manufacturing facility is. So tell us a little bit about the impact that you've been able to create on all these fronts.
See, I think it's a long-term vision, and we are trying to see that what can be done. There's a saying that boon boon se ghada bata hai. Theek hai, we are still not satisfied the way we are trying to do, but I can definitely say that we have done a lot of work, a lot to be done. And particularly on environment side, if I talk, I mean, we know what is the value of water.
Yeah.
In Kutch, when we were getting the water almost like 350 kilometers of pipeline from Narmada for our use, and suddenly the last couple of years there is hardly any rain, and is always having a, you know, issue of water. So we put up the first STP, sewage treatment plant, from the nearby areas. We spent almost 150 crore and putting that treatment plant, almost like 30 MLD of water we are treating every day. And we are using for our all manufacturing units, be it textile, be it steel or be it pipes. And we have released almost like 10 MLD of water, which was sanctioned for us for the neighboring nearby villages and the small towns there.
Right. So in Hyderabad, with the new plant coming in place, what sort of CSR initiatives are going to be tied down with?
So basic philosophies remain same. I mean, one of the area is that nearby villages, we try to convert into model village.
Like we have model cities, right? Why don't we have something like a model village? So we thought about this concept, and, you know, firstly thought about it as to what do you think should be constituting a model village. And it evolved from something like a village which is healthy and village where people are happy, right? And they have a source of livelihood. They have all the essential infrastructure which they have. So we started with this project, and we're working in three villages, where we firstly taking care of all the essential infrastructure which is related to the sanitation, which is related to the roads, the pathways, the street lighting, and all the other infrastructure which is required, the primary health center, the schools, the improvement which is required in those areas. So we did that.
Yes.
Today there is a lot of concern for the environment the world over, the climate change, as well as everything that corporates or urban citizens are doing to really destroy the environment. So at Welspun, what has the philosophy been in terms of going green? What sort of practices have you put in place?
We have a huge drive also on the plantation, on the greenery. Almost our target is putting 1 million trees by 2020. I mean, because of the water shortage earlier, we could not achieve the target. But I can tell you today, we are almost having 400,000 plants. We have done it. So we want to be, my personal mission is that we don't want to have a garden in a factory, but factory should be in a garden. That should be the, when you get into a Welspun city in Anjar, that should be the feeling you should get.
Okay, and as far as CSR is concerned, what's the vision that you've
got? CSR, as I said, it is in our DNA. I mean, whether businesses are ups or down, I think we are on that path. We are very clear that we are going to take it to the next level. It's not a question of spending 15 crore, 20 crore, 25 crore, 50 crore, 100 crore. At the end, it has to be sustainable. We have to create an impact. So whatever we want to touch, whether it is empowering women, whether it is environment, whether it is education, whatever, we have to create some kind of impact which is sustainable. Otherwise, you know, just for the namesake that, okay, we have done this, we have done that, that is not going to help help the society.
All right. Thank you very much for joining us, Mr. Goenka. On that note, let's head into a short break right now. But stay with us as we continue to find out what makes Welspun one of India's most responsible companies right here on CNBC TV 18. Welcome back to India's Most Responsible Companies. On the show today, we're exploring all that Welspun India is doing to give back to society. We're here at the fantastic factories of Welspun India at Anjar, the oldest town of Kutch district in Gujarat that was in fact devastated by the earthquake in 2001. Since then, Welspun has stepped in and really helped local communities build the town of Anjar back. And we're now joined by the CEO and joint MD of the company, Dipali Goenka, to tell us more about all that Welspun India has been doing here to give back to society. Dipali, let me begin from the beginning. You're someone who got married into a business family. You spent about a decade of your life bringing up your kids. And then one fine day, you wanted to do something more than just being a homemaker, and you learned the ropes, started learning the ropes at Welspun India. When and how did you get into the CSR initiatives? You're a CEO who led some of the most profitable years of the company. But as far as giving back to society is concerned, how and when did that journey begin?
It actually began in 2003 when we were setting up the factories in Anjar here. It happened when, you know, I mean, it got devastated by a massive earthquake. Everything was demolished. And we were setting up a factory here. We also realized that, you know, can businesses be the agent of change? We had been working in a certain manner, and we realized that we need to make a difference. So hence our journey began. And it began with small steps. It began with a journey where we wanted to set up a school for not only our people, our Welspunites who came in here, but also for the communities. Here, there were first generation children who were going to school as well. So that was very, very interesting. And hence the first step started from a school there.
And today, what are all the various focus areas as far as Welspun's CSR initiatives are concerned here in Anjar as well as elsewhere in the country?
So for us at Welspun, the key is women. And they hold the key to the progress of a country. And that's what we believe in at Welspun as well. Because when you look at it overall, if you even look at the global, the Indian demographics, you will see that 29% women are employed vis-a-vis, and it's fallen to from 35 to 29%. I feel that the interesting thing is that if we can get more women, you're employing, you know, not only the 100% of the population, but, you know, you're also getting a lot of commitment from them. When a woman gets to work, I think the children get educated, the families get educated and progressive, and that's what we have taken forward.
मैंने यहाँ पे करीब 5.5 साल पहले वेल्समन में ज्वाइन किया था एज ए ट्रेनी विविन टेरिटोरियल में और उसके बाद फिर कंपनी की तरफ से एक ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम स्टार्ट हुआ था वुमेन एम्पावरमेंट के रिलेटेड उसी के थ्रू फिर मुझे एक अपॉर्चुनिटी दी गई कंपनी की तरफ से कि मैं एज ए ट्रेनर के तौर पर काम कर सकती हूँ वहाँ पर हम लोगों को TOT दिया गया जहाँ पर हमें ट्रेनिंग कैसे देनी है वो चीज़ सिखाई गई और उसके बाद फिर वहाँ पे परफॉर्मेंस अच्छा होने की वजह से कंपनी ने प्रमोट किया कि आपको ट्रेनिंग डिपार्टमेंट में ट्रांसफ़र करते हैं और अभी आपको ट्रेनी नहीं लेकिन एज ए ट्रेनर के तौर पे वर्क करना है तो एक मेरे लिए एक प्लेटफॉर्म था कि जो स्टडी मेरा नहीं हो पाया था कहीं ना कहीं रह गया था 12th के बाद वो एक अपॉर्चुनिटी मिले कि मैं अपना स्किल अपना डेवलपमेंट वहाँ पर एक स्टेज प्लेटफॉर्म पर दिखा सकती हूँ लोगों को दूसरा उसके उससे भी ज़्यादा ज़रूरी चीज़ ये थी कि जो चीज़ मुझे सीखने मिले या मेरे अंदर जो एम्पावरमेंट आया कॉन्फिडेंस आया वो चीज़ मुझे दूसरी लेडीज़ के अंदर भी इंक्रीज़ करने का मौका मिला
सो यू आर इन्वॉल्व विद एजुकेशन यू आर इन्वॉल्व विद वुमेन्स एम्पावरमेंट यू आर ऑल्सो डूइंग स्टफ अराउंड हेल्थ एंड सैनिटेशन एंड वेलफेयर ऑफ द पीपल हियर इज़न्ट इट
सो हेल्थ एंड सैनिटेशन कम्स एज एन इंटेग्रल पार्ट ऑफ व्हाट वी आर डूइंग हियर सो व्हेन यू you know, we started doing camps here and health camps. We realized that, you know, women were inflicted by cervical cancer, men by throat cancer. And we realized there's a lot of need of, things that we needed to do here. Sanitary napkins became a very interesting initiative for us because we felt for women, most of the women were not using sanitary napkins here.
So you established a sanitary napkin making unit at WAPI, isn't it?
At WAPI, so that the women, I mean, we now have around 7 entrepreneurs there who are earning their living, and they are also influencing a lot of women to use sanitary napkins and also become entrepreneurs as well. And that's the same thing that we want to get into the different communities that we are working in, not only at Welspun India Anjar, but also at the infrastructure area, locations that we are going to be, whether it's going to be north of India, Telangana, where our plant for rugs is coming in, and all over the country.
And you make a conscious effort to employ a lot of women from this area. So what's the percentage of women in your workforce here today? And again, how challenging was it to bring women into the workforce? Because this is an area that has been conservative traditionally. Women don't get out of the house, even though they are extremely, extremely talented as far as art and craft is concerned.
So the first thing here was that you are absolutely right. They all work within their own communities and the tribes. So the first thing was to make them secure. Make them secure in the sense of wherever they'll be working, they'll be able to take care of the children as well. So we have a PPP where we have these kind of community centers where they come in, they work, and they have the children also there if they want to, and they can go back to their homes when they are required to. So one step at a time that we took forward with our initiative called Spun. And there the women are not only translating the rags to a product which is a cushion and a rug made out of the pit looms or done with their heritage, which is translated in the versatile world of international tastes. So I think that's where, you know, these women are working on, and we got them on board.
So Spun centers, they're working with rags, basically.
They're working with rags and the, you know, heritage, which is translated by the global taste as well. So we have our designers working with them as well.
पहले एक ही कमाने वाला था, तो थोड़ी दिक्कत होती थी. अब मैं कमाने लग गई हूँ, सेंटर में आती हूँ. जो भी पैसे मिलते हैं, तो अच्छे से कपड़े उसको खरीद के देती हूँ, किताबें. पहले बाहर पढ़ाई करने के सोचते थे कि कैसे पढ़ाएंगे, कैसे फीस भरेंगे. अभी यहाँ आने से, काम करने से पैसे मिलते हैं, तो उसकी फीस भरती हूँ.
So the whole idea is about a woman being secure. So we set up a girls' hostel here as well. So here, not only the girls from the communities, but the girls from all over the country come and stay there, making them secure, making them know that they are here not only to earn their living, but also to grow in their journey. So they're getting educated here as well. They're growing. I have a path planned for them so that they know that, you know, they're not just going to be doing what they are doing. They can become managers, they can become supervisors. And that's where, you know...
And you've had many of those success stories over the years.
Yeah, we have actually. And the unit that you see here is run by women. And the head of this place was a GET. And she has, you know, sprung up from, you know, kind of the bottom rung to where she is today, and she's running this whole unit here.
I joined here as a management trainee back in 2005, and now I'm heading this plant. So I've always got this new roles and responsibilities with Welspun, and every time I get a new opportunity, I feel elevated. I feel like I've contributed something to the organization, and organization has also accepted and always given support and always motivated us with more and more of responsibilities and positions. This plant of Welspun, the W2 plant, is more about empowerment. Here we don't just employ female, but we empower them. So the empowering here means they come here when they were not knowing anything about stitching, but when they come here, we teach them the basic stitching, the specialized stitching. They also know how to handle their own machine, like the maintenance part of it. So it's a complete empowerment.
The government has this whole Skill India mission where they're planning to skill millions of youth over the next couple of years. Over here in the Kutch region, you're of course on that mission for the last couple of years, over a decade now. What sort of skill development initiatives have you had, and what's the impact you've been able to create with those?
I think the skill development is a very integral part of the rural India. And I think when we talk about textiles, they become the biggest employer of the rural India. So we have partnered with a government here and taking on skill, where we have actually skilled around 10,000 people year on year, and not only for our factories, but also for different needs, where they're looking at plumbing, they're looking at various other vocational needs that can be.
Great. And finally, what is your long-term vision for the CSR initiatives at Welspun India, say 10 to 15 years down the line? How do you picture it?
You know, I picture these, all our employees being smart, and smart in the sense of technology, smart in the sense of handling the IoTs and AIs and computer literacy, which will be not second to anyone in the world. And that's where our journey will be. And we have just commenced on that journey, where we'll see lot of our employees getting into that. And that's where, so it is a very interesting thing. As we progress, the communities progress. And as the communities progress, the world will progress.
Great. It's been wonderful talking to you, Dipali. Thank you so much for joining us on the show today.
Thank you.
Well, with that, it's a wrap of this episode of India's Most Responsible Companies. We'll be back next time with another inspiring tale of a corporate from India showing you how business can be done with a heart. Thank you for joining us. Goodbye.
Focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable.